My name is Jeannet Molopyane. I'm the Deputy Director for Teaching and Learning Information Services in the library. The OERs are a new project for the University of the Free State, and they reside in my division. So we are taking on this new project with excitement. We are looking forward to ensuring that it succeeds so that a wealth of information resources can be made available to our students.
For those students and lecturers who have no idea what open educational resources are, how would you explain to them what it is?
To explain OERs to people who don't know, I'll say it in full that they are open educational resources. They are material that can be used for teaching, learning, and research, and they reside in the public domain, and they have to be under intellectual property licensing, under Creative Commons licensing that permits the resources to be used freely, and they can be repurposed by others. So that's what OERs are. And then they are freely available online. They include course materials for module, they include modules, they include textbooks, they include streaming videos, tests, softwares, and many other tools that are used to support learning of students. And if I may add the importance of OERs, right now, what we are experiencing globally with the pandemic, money is going to be a scarce resource and more information will be needed. So students won't be able to procure textbooks. We have seen universities globally have been with different businesses to ensure that, you know, they acquire e-books, but still that is still expensive. So OERs are a way to go.
How would you convince a lecturer to put in the time and effort to create these textbooks for the benefit of the students?
If I have to inspire academics to create OERs, it will be for what the mandate of higher education stands for, to ensure that knowledge is freely available in order to build up the economies of our country so that we produce skills. And with the OERs, the lecturer, the way they package their content, is going to make sure that our students get the right knowledge. And then the knowledge that is not expensive, OERs are freely available. So it means that even the poorest of the poor, that young man, Tabo, who stays with Gogo in an informal settlement and cannot afford a textbook, Tabo, who stays with Gogo, who lives on pension grants, is able to get an information resource that will enable him to be alleviated from poverty and also improve the livelihood of himself and Gogo. So OERs are really a wonderful tool that will contribute towards, you know, taking our country to a different level, especially under the circumstances that the country is currently facing. Therefore, I will encourage academics to say, you know, for us to, because now the economies of the countries are down. So in order for us to make sure that we contribute strategically the other way, we will have to make sure that we have OERs that will make sure that there is enough information resources that are freely available. And on the other hand, it is going to put the reputation of the academic up there, because now the whole world will be able to see what they are doing. Look at what MIT is doing with regard to OERs. They are prescribing their OERs as teaching and learning material because they are confident with the content that they produce. And when you look at MIT, not that I'm speaking about MIT, it's one of the best ranking universities. So we as the University of the Free State, we are also looking into that to make sure that, you know, we produce our own content that we are confident with, that we know that is going to contribute to the growth of this country.
Okay, so it needs to be a quality OER. So one of the questions that I hear a lot, for example, is how will the university ensure that the open educational resources that is published will be of good quality?
Indeed, OERs have to be of quality. Remember the reputation and integrity of the university is also affected. Therefore, we have to make sure that the quality that of the OERs that are produced are of the highest standards. Therefore, before an OER can be placed on our Figshare platform, the head of department has to evaluate. And then we as the library, again, we will have to make sure that we look whether it complies with a copyright licensing and Creative Commons licensing. But the most important part, we emphasize Creative Commons licensing. And then the other thing that we are also emphasizing is that when academics want to develop their own OERs, they must look at the OERs that are already under the Creative Commons licensing state. Then those are the OERs that we are going to encourage academics to use, so that at the end of the day we know that what we have is credible, is of quality, and then we can comfortably share it with the world to make sure that our reputation as an institution remains intact, and as well as the academic. Also, it will also add on the student output that we produce, that we will have confidence to say, the quality of the material that we have produced has produced a quality graduates who are employable and who are entrepreneurial as well.
Okay, so if you've got the lecturer excited now, where can they go for support?
At the moment, the library has dispersed the librarians in collaboration with CTL, because this is a collaborative project. We have dispersed our librarians to approach the departments. We have presented our OERs at the respective faculty board meetings. So the librarians are out there in the faculties to make sure that they are showing the lecturers the examples of OERs that are there, as well as what are OERs, and CTL will assist with how to develop their curriculum to ensure that it's linked with a Creative Commons licensing. So we are playing that role. Both of us are playing that role, and we are very excited about it, because this is new. When something is new, people are always nervous, but we are very excited because we know the good that is going to come out of this. So we have a platform on Figshare, and again, we have a LibGuide. And then we are still doing more research. We are not saying we are busy with this. We are still conducting more research with regards to OERs, because now the move in the world is OERs. So we are also raising our voice as the University of the Free State to say the world, the University of the Free State is moving to OERs. What I can say about OERs, like I mentioned earlier, it is going to, there's this thing called information poverty. So when we speak of information poverty, is when people lack information of quality. So OERs will be a wonderful platform to produce quality information, the information that will be used by our students. And then it is also going to inspire other universities. I know in the country, the universities that have adopted OERs is UCT, is UNISA, and it's VETS University. So last year, one of our colleagues, Mr. Monde Madiba, presented a paper at the LIASA conference with regards to OERs. So colleagues were asking us about OERs. Luckily, we had a platform then. Then we could tell them that, yes, we do have OERs. We do have a platform. So it was a big thing for us as a University of the Free State. Now it says now the world can see that we are doing something that they are not, I mean, the country. We are doing something that they are not yet doing. They are only reading about it, but we have moved a step forward. We have implemented a OERs as the University of the Free State. And I'm also glad that at the moment we have structures, we have templates, so academics have somewhere to start from. So it's not going to be a difficult thing. It's only the how part. So for us, it's the how part, and then we hope to see some outputs before the end of this year. Yes, so we have adopted the OERs, we have marketed them vigorously, now we are implementing, we are moving into the implementation stage. And after implementing them, we will make noise about them. We'll tell the world about how we have OERs, and we will share with the world how effective are they. We will share with the world how are they used, so that we also, because it's important for our voice to be heard out there, so that others can be inspired by what we are doing, and in as much as others are inspiring us with what they are doing.